Good morning and welcome to the Worship of God with Center Congregational Church. I'm Reverend Nancy Roatman, pastor and teacher of Center Church. We are an open and affirming congregation of the United Church of Christ located in Lynnfield, Massachusetts. It is good to welcome you to worship this morning. We continue with our Easter season because Easter isn't just one day. Today we hear Jesus say, "Do not let your hearts be troubled." The early church knew that Christ went before them to prepare a place, and so they prepared a place for each other in this way. Day by day, as they spent much time together in the temple, they broke bread at home and ate their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God and having the goodwill of all the people. We create a temple of worship in our hearts that connects us across boundaries, distance, and time. But as we share this worship, we will stay connected. At the heart of the matter, we are connected through the Spirit that makes us one in love. Won't you take a moment to center yourselves and breathe with me? Let's take a deep breath in, breathe in peace, and breathe out love. And let us pray together, repeating after me. Holy living God, heartbeat of creation, help us to take this time to center on you, for you made us, you gave us life, and you continue to be with us every moment, every breath, every step. Let us pick up our heart stone, sometimes called a worry stone, and let our touch on its surface remind us that God's touch is within us, between us, and around us, as close and real as this object is in our hands right now, is how close love is to us always. Let us imagine letting go of our worries for now into God's heart of love. We'll join together now in singing "God's Eye is on the Sparrow." Watch for the lyrics on your screen and sing along from home.
God's eye is
When we listen to the gospel text today, we will hear images of the house that God has prepared for all. Jesus says that when we remember him and know him in our hearts, we know God. As we sit around this meal in our houses, because we ask Jesus to be with us, we sit in that house of God in spirit with all others as well. Let us pray this repeat after me prayer. God, our host, we gather in your name, invited by Jesus, bound together with your spirit, in union with each other. Feed our bodies and our spirits with your comfort and presence, so that we might be your comfort and presence to others. Bless this food. Break open our hearts. And bless this drink. And pour out your love. Amen. And now, I hope you'll enjoy this prayer over the meal with the Davis family.
Bless the food before us. Bless the family beside us and the love between us. Amen. Let's feast!
That's good.
All right.
That's very cute. Sharon. And Claudia. Mason. And Mason. And the papa. Thank you for the grace.
The psalm today mentions something that we've been using throughout our Easter season, our rocks. God is described many times in the Bible as a rock, as something that is a solid foundation and a shelter in times of distress. Hear the trust of the writer, even as hard times are upon them.
I take refuge in you, Lord. Please never let me be put to shame. Rescue me by your righteousness. Listen closely to me. Deliver me quickly. Be a rock that protects me. Be a strong fortress that saves me. You are definitely my rock and my fortress. Guide me and lead me for the sake of your good name. Get me out of this net that's been set for me, because you are my protective fortress. I entrust my spirit into your hands. You, Lord, God of faithfulness, you have saved me. My future is in your hands. Don't hand me over to my enemies, to all who are out to get me. Shine your face on your servant. Save me by your faithful love.
Our future is in the hands of love, in the heart of God. Jesus, as God in the flesh, helps us to know that we are in the house and family of God. He called God Abba, an intimate name that a child would call a parent in the language Jesus spoke. God was not distant, but a parent who loves tenderly, protects faithfully, and wants to know us intimately. Hear Jesus comfort the disciples who are distressed at the thought of living without him.
Don't let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith in me as well. In God's house, there are many dwelling places. Otherwise, how could I have told you that I was going to prepare a place for you? I am indeed going to prepare a place for you, and then I will come back to take you with me, that where I am, there you may be as well. You know the way that leads to where I'm going. Thomas replied, "But we don't know where you're going. How can we know the way?" Jesus told him, "I myself am the way. I am truth, and I am life. No one comes to Abba God but through me. If you really knew me, you would know Abba God also. From this point on, you know Abba God as you and you have seen God." "Rabbi," Philip said, "show us Abba God, and that will be enough for us." Jesus replied, "Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and still you don't know me? Whoever has seen me has seen Abba God. How can you say, 'Show us your Abba'? Don't you believe that I am in Abba God and God is in me? The words I speak are not spoken of myself. It is Abba God living in me who is accomplishing the works of God. Believe me that I am in God and God is in me, and else believe because of the works I do. The heart and the truth of the matter is, anyone who has faith in me will do the works I do, and greater works beside. Why? Because I go to Abba God, and whatever you ask in my name, I will do, so that God may be glorified in me. Anything you ask in my name, I will do.
Jesus himself cried out to God from the Hebrew scriptures that were his holy texts, saying the words we read today, "Into your hands I commit my spirit." This is the kind of relationship with God that he wanted us to have, to be able to let go of our need to control the future, our anxiety about what is going to happen, which we cannot know right now, and let God comfort us. Jesus reminded his disciples, and he reminds us, to trust in God when our hearts are troubled. It is okay to be troubled, but we can also know that even while our minds may be working overtime, our hearts can rest assured in God's love. Friends, if we are going to understand and live a life that honors God as our refuge and our shelter in times of distress, we have to first acknowledge the truth of our own vulnerability. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Jesus spoke those words to his disciples just as the trouble was really ramping up. And here we are hearing these words from Jesus again, right in the midst of our own heap of trouble. And here we are recalling the psalmist's appeal for safety to the protective fortress that is our God, our salvation. What Thomas's "but" betrays and the psalmist's words point to is an attitude that is largely denigrated in our society, and that is one of vulnerability, confusion, fear, even powerlessness. In a society where power is wielded like a sword, admitting that we are, in fact, unable to truly control this pandemic is a scary prospect. It involves a return to Ash Wednesday, to be marked by our own mortality and living from there. Jesus tells the disciples to not be troubled even as there are mountains of trouble ahead. He does not offer a false sense of security. He warns them what is coming and then reminds them that they carry a safe haven, a peaceful dwelling place right within them. I started a yoga practice this week. As I have begun walking several miles a day again, I have exacerbated the tightness in my body. I also believe that tightness grows worse whenever I allow fear, worry, uncertainty, or lack of control overtake me. My body tenses up for the fight. I knew I needed to find a way to offer my body the strengthening, lengthening, unkinking, letting go that it needs for both my physical, emotional, and spiritual health. And of course, what I found was yet another affirmation that the peaceful, safe haven that God offers, the refuge from trouble Jesus is talking about, is within me, within each of us. At my request, our daughter Colleen sent me links to several gentle beginning yoga videos to get me started. Several of them were by a woman named Adrienne. I loved her immediately. The video I've been using to practice each day is called "A Little Goes a Long Way." She is totally speaking my language. There are three things that Adrienne says or encourages that totally connect to that place of deep refuge within ourselves. The place where God abides in us. The place we're searching for in any contemplative practice. Each of her instructions are about breathing. Remembering that breath and spirit are connected, Adrienne tells us that the breathing practice, pranayama, is as important and as challenging as the shapes, the asanas. The second is the direction of the breath. The in-breath travels down into our center, does a little somersault there, and then travels upwards on the way out. And the third reminder is to breathe like you love yourself. And there, right there, is the heart of the matter. This is the way, a way, perhaps the way, to live through the current trouble or any trouble that comes our way. I take refuge in you, Lord. It just so happens that refuge is within us, and the way there is through our breathing, through minding our breath. In this worship series, we have practiced breathing together each week. We have practiced breathing in peace and breathing out love. Perhaps the key to not letting our hearts be troubled is as ordinary and extraordinary as connecting to our breath. It is working for me. What if you try it for yourself? When you breathe in, picture peace traveling in and down to the center of your being. Imagine what that center place looks like. Picture it as the peaceful abode you hope for in God's house. Maybe just comforting, warm darkness. Imagine that peace you have breathed in to be just what that place needs, the breath that it needs to endure. And then let the nourishment of that peace, that breath, be transformed to somersault into the love that you breathe out into your own life. This moment of abiding with God is as close to you as your own breathing. It is available to you no matter the trouble that swirls around you or your inability to control, mitigate, or eliminate that trouble. We remember that the only way out of trouble is right through it. We can make our way through, acknowledging that while we don't have any idea what lies ahead, we can be both comforted and empowered by God's accompanying presence as the Christ within us. Remember, a little goes a long way. Remember to breathe like you love yourself and like God loves you, because indeed your breath, your life, comes from God. When we do that, we're bound to be far less troubled and to breathe out more love into our lives and the lives of those beside us. Friends, do not let your hearts be troubled. Amen. On this day when, in our secular world, we honor mothers everywhere, I realize how fraught this day can be for so many. So today, in honor of all of our mothers, no matter how complicated or blessed our relationships are, let us pray to our beloved Mother God, in whom we all live and move and have our being. Let us pray. Blessed are mothers, our mothers, all mothers, for their wholehearted yet imperfect love. Despite our distance, may we offer wholehearted expressions of our deep gratitude. Blessed are all women who long to be mothers, but are not yet, or perhaps ever to be. May they know your consolation, O God, and be blessed with outlets for their nurturing that bring peace to their aching hearts. Blessed are all of us who are missing our mothers this day, whether our separation is due to restrictions or due to death. May we search our hearts to know their love that remains part of us forever and always. Blessed are all mothers who are grieving, whose arms ache with emptiness and loss, especially all who are unjustly separated from their children. Today we say her name, Wanda Jones, mother of Armand Arbery, who birthed him on Mother's Day in 1994. Blessed are those who have suffered at their mother's side. That healing and wholeness and nurturing love be theirs within you, O God. Blessed are all women who choose not to be mothers, for we recognize babies are not the only new life we are capable of and called to birth into the world. Blessed are those of all genders who have mothered us and loved us as our mothering God loves us. Blessed are the teachers who are conduits of love and connection for our children. Blessed are the nurses who are love in action in all times, and in this time they are our love in all the places of caregiving where we cannot be. Blessed are the mask wearers who help prevent passing on of illness. Blessed are the mask makers who are blessing us with their craft. Blessed are the ones on the front lines who are doing their part to slow the spread, care for the sick, and provide emergency support. Blessed are the grocery laborers, the sanitation workers, the hospital janitors, essential workers who make our lives possible. Blessed are all who stay home. Blessed are the stressed out, the tired, the anxious, the lonely, for we are alone together. Blessed are you when you lose it, because you are human. Blessed be, blessed be, blessed be. We pray this in the name of Jesus, born of Mary, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Good morning, Center Church friends. It is wonderful to be together with you on this very chilly May morning. I hope that you're enjoying a warm beverage, a cup of coffee or tea, and feeling very cozy at home. I wanted to share with you a little bit about having goodwill, as we have been doing each week in our service, and having a chance to talk about ideas that help us share those things that we are experiencing during this Easter season with others. We are, as Christians, indeed a people of hope, and we want to share that hope with others. So in that spirit, the town of Linfield is holding a Better Days Ahead parade this coming Saturday, May 16th. It will start at 9:45 at the Linfield Middle School, and folks can assemble there. You are asked to please, please follow the guidelines of social distancing while you are assembling. And then at 10 o'clock, the parade will proceed to the Summer Street Teacher Parade route and then follow the Huckleberry route. So what we're asking folks to do is to make a lawn sign or come and chalk our walk or even participate from your homes with a sign of hope as the parade proceeds through the streets of Linfield. And what we thought is that we could really show what it means to be the center of life in Linfield in this very concrete way. I myself am going to attempt to recreate this sign of hope. Autumn has promised to help me. I'm sure it won't be this professional looking, but it is so important in these times to really garner the hope that we have in Christ and share that with others. I should mention that the parade is going to have a particular focus on essential workers. So this week, please intentionally pray for our essential workers. They do not have a choice about whether or not they leave their homes on any given day. They are doctors and nurses and home health care aides and firefighters and police officers. They are our heroes among us, and they are helping to keep us safe. So please keep them in mind this week, the grocery store workers and folks who are running businesses that are essential to us in this time. Also, please pray for those who are not able to run their businesses, those small businesses that might be suffering at this time. So until we are together physically, let us be together in heart and in spirit as we share the hope that we have with the Linfield community this Saturday, May 16th, in the Better Days Ahead Parade.
Last week, Lorraine shared with us the idea of filling a bucket. She shared about how that image is used to encourage our children to pay attention to both how they are treated and how they treat others. And Lorraine also shared about literally filling a bucket, box, or bag with what we can to care for our neighbors who are hungry. Many of you are doing just that. I've shared a wonderful song down in the comments called Drop in the Bucket by Carla Glover and her musical group Zoe Speaks. It reminds us that we are called to be a drop in the mighty stream of justice. We're not called to be the whole mighty stream ourselves, but just a drop in the bucket. Please see this week's Tower Notes newsletter posted on our website for more information on the ways that our mission and outreach committee is matching your donations to organizations that are helping in this time of pandemic. Throughout this time of being together apart, the mission and ministries of Center Church are ongoing, and your support as you are able is graciously received. You may mail your pledges or contribution to the church office or also give online. Just click the online giving button on our website homepage. I'd like to thank those of you who have given additional funds to the Pastor's Discretionary Fund, from which I offer support on behalf of the whole congregation to those who are struggling in these challenging times. There was a donation made to the fund this weekend in honor of mothers. Thank you. Just as God dwells in us, we dwell in God. We share space together in the life of God where all have their needs met and none go unnoticed. We live, too, in this world that is aching with hunger, economic injustice, and housing inequity, in hopes of doing our part to embody the kingdom among us in the here and now. We bring what we have to God and each other. Let us pray now a prayer of dedication for all that we have given and all that we will give. Let us pray. Incarnate One, there is no knowledge of you apart from each other. We confess that we often act as if it were not so. We search high and low for you while you wait for us in the face of our neighbors and the body of the earth. In all your many forms, You come to us with offerings and asks. May our gifts be a sign of our gratitude for every holy encounter, the ones recognized and the ones still unnoticed. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen. It is time to praise God and raise our endorphin levels to improve our heart health, both physically and spiritually. So whether your dance is in your bed, in your chair, or all over the living room, it's time for the Easter season dance party. If you're going to dance standing up, go ahead and get ready. And let's start with this affirmation, repeating after me. We know Jesus is present among us, even in this very home. We will not let fear be louder than love, but with glad hearts and rejoicing souls, we will sing God's praise, for we are Easter people. Friends, receive this blessing. Let not your hearts be troubled. God has chosen to make a home in us. In a way, the whole cosmos, everyone we have ever loved, everyone who is still yet to be, all that is birthed by life and love abides in us. There is nothing around us that is not also within. And so we are sent to practice love towards every living thing, knowing that all is connected and our hope rests in each other. Amen. So let's dance together, letting it come from the heart. This week is a slow and cherished one. Click the link below in the description of the video to join in our postlude jam, Bridge Over Troubled Water by Simon and Garfunkel.